Hello, everybody. This is Henry Lee, BlueHeronArts.com. Today, we're going to do another Etagami painting on this fruit. It's called a golden kiwi from New Zealand. Let's take a look of the details. I'm going to cut this in half and paint it with another together. Here we go. You can see the color of the pulp. It's very different from regular green kiwi. It's a golden kiwi, sweet kiwi. We're going to do an ink outline first. And I got some leftover paints. So I use a little bit peach glue sap water to dilute it. This will make the ink reusable, otherwise it's not fluid anymore. It has like a little powder or like a pastel instead of a liquid ink. So I now blend it with a peach sap glue powder. I have a bottle of it ready. Just in hand. I held the brush at a high position. This is the norm of the Etagami painting. So I do not use too much control. However, I do have to develop a mind image before I paint. And, you know, a composition. Also, the final result, you need to imagine it. All the technique is to try to reach that mind image. So the most beautiful painting is always in your mind to begin with. The paper I'm using is called a semi-sized shrine. You can see that it absorbs but not bleed that much as a regular shrine. This gives me time to think sometimes needed. So I don't have to paint as quickly as on the regular shrine. Note the oval shape of the golden kiwi, different from the regular kiwi. Especially on this four fruit. There's a little extruding, what do you call this, the remains of the style. So I mimic the beginner look of kind of lines. So the imperfect is perfect, or wabi-sabi in Japanese. And the next thing I'm going to do is to wash. And I use a soft sheep hair flour brush. So soak the brush first. I use a little bit Chinese gamboge color, which is a very intense yellow. And I use a little bit other color, a little bit the carmine left on the palette to make it golden. And very important to keep the to not fill up the space. So you need not to fill up. Just keep white. I need another more seat on this side. So I will finish the wash. I don't use white, just leave the background white. We can use a little bit of ink in the color to the fruits. It's a very light ink. I cannot roll the brush instead of push it or drag it. This will avoid tearing the paper. To make the color thin enough, you will not only create the texture, the fuzz, and also to make the color looks less muddy and nicer. Finally, I will touch a little bit mineral green color with the yellow and some red to make it a jungle green, a kind of a greenish gray. Okay, well, it smears, but that's okay. You can use a blotting paper if you want to stop it. Just use a facial tissue. Paper towel has too much texture, so you want to use tissue. Sometimes it will also reduce the intensity. That's a trade-off if you use blotting paper. Just use a facial tissue. Paper towel has too much texture, so you want to use tissue. Sometimes it will also reduce the intensity. That's a trade-off if you use blotting paper. So you have to add more color after that. But when you mount it, it will come back to the to return the restore the intensity. Okay, now I'm going to write something. I use Sumi ink. Okay, I'll make up a little bit here, the bottom part. Okay, the title I'm going to give inscription, it would be just a straight the name of the fruit in Chinese, Huangjing. It smears, but that's okay. Just keep going, and you will have a dry stroke balance that. So don't worry about any incident. Imperfection is perfect. Says golden kiwi, and I'll write the price tag on it, just for the record. It says 99 each. finally, I put the label from the fruit on the painting. The time to take the fruit. Very delicious. Thanks for watching. Goodbye.